It's QuantTrade Edge, and today we had a lot of action in the S&P. We had this very large gap down that happened after the CPI number pre-market. How could we have known this was going to happen? Well, the answer is right there. Yesterday afternoon from about 1:30, I'm sorry, 8:30, 9 a.m. Yeah, so basically between the afternoon of Friday and the early morning of Monday, we made this flat flag. And this flat flag broke out to the upside and then came down and failed all very quickly, which is the hallmark of a top. And then we went sideways for one, two, three, four, for basically an hour and a half. We went sideways, and this would have been a great time to pick up puts, for this move that happened here. I picked up some puts, not nearly as many as I should have, but in hindsight's 2020. But just the from buying puts in here to the open was a 3x, and down towards the lows it was closer to a 5x. So that was that would have been the play based on seeing this flat flag break out and fail. Now, this flat flag again today, we saw it again in here where this area was kind of a flat flag breakdown and a quick failure. And this led to a 30-point rally in 30 minutes. And that was a very vicious rally. Now, again, a lot of this stuff is wonderful. It's backwards looking. How does that help anyone? Well, it's actually stuff that we call live in our chat room. So you can see this picture that I posted. The timestamp on it is 2 p.m. yesterday. And you can see it's before the rest of these bars formed. We'd already identified this flat flag, the rally up, the breakdown, and said, could that be a flat flag on the 30-minute? And then this morning, or this afternoon, starting at 2:29, we highlighted this flat flag before we had even broken out from it. Watching 2-minute ES to see if we take out the highs of that flat flag. And then here I posted another picture once we did take out the highs of that flat flag, and I said, we did. Hope you caught a piece of that. Here we're getting in towards the MLC. We've already moved about 15, 20 points from there. And then I even mentioned that we should get a good MOC, just a matter of which way. And I did a whole separate video recording the MOC live. We caught over 10 points on that trade in 5 minutes. And also just, a little point here on the VXX, just seeing that the VXX had put in that type of a, whatever you'd call that kind of climax. That was just more confirmation for the afternoon rally. So those are the kind of things you can look forward to on our Discord channel if you become a member. We're just looking at price action and technical analysis on a variety of markets, S&P being one of them. And, any one of these insights, catching 30 points to the upside, catching 10 points on the MOC, or having an hour and a half to position into puts yesterday afternoon before today happened. Any and all of those were, massive trade opportunities. And those are the kind of things that we focus on in just a no-nonsense, blocking and tackling, homework every day, ask questions, answer questions, point out what we see, try to keep it real simple because we're actually busy trading. So anyway, hopefully everybody caught a piece of that move today, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.